Thank you, thank you. A good crowd tonight, a good crowd. Welcome to Marty's Corner. I'm your host, Marty Shields, and this is our another excursion to live TV from Channel 33 here at CAT Channel 33 in the City of Industry. Beautiful City of Industry. CAT Channel 33 in the City of Industry. We go live, unlike some of the other talk shows that go on tape delay. No, we're riding the edge. We're not messing around. We go live, and if it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, we'll cut it all up and make it look good. What's going on around lately? This evening, in fact, something's going on that doesn't happen too often. I guess it's a once-in-a-lifetime event. A celestial body here in the universe will be pummeled and pierced by a bunch of comets. They will pierce the outer layer of this heavenly body, and we're not talking about Madonna. No. It's a different heavenly body. It's Jupiter. And so if any of you are stargazers, about 12 o'clock tonight, go on out and take a look-see. The other thing is, I realized something as I was watching TV the other day. Have you watched those cop shows they have on TV, Cops, and True Life Stories of the detectives and all that kind of stuff? There's a universal truth. There are certain things in life that are universal truths that transcend all time. And one of those things is, on one of those shows, if you see a cop car pulling into a trailer park, the first guy they see without a shirt, he's the guy who did it. Yeah. It doesn't matter. The first guy comes running up without a shirt, he did it. Something about male Americans, when they get drunk, they can't find their shirts. Did you notice that? I noticed that. We'd like to talk about something that's going to be happening next month on Marty's Corner. That's our one-year anniversary here at Marty's Corner. One-year anniversary. Yay! And let me go ahead and Norma, I'm going to come to you. I have the official flyer. This is a hot commodity. This is the official flyer for the one-year anniversary show at the VFW Hall. Last month, we said it was going to be the 12th of August. We've made a change of that. Now it's the 19th. We give ourselves one more week to freak out. Is that right? Beautiful. Well, like I said, we'd like you to go ahead and get involved in this. And... would you get away from me? And come on down. That'll be August 19th from 8 to 10 at the VFW Hall. $5 donation goes to the POWMIA Foundation. And we really implore you to please come down and not only support us, but also support the guys down at the VFW Hall and some of the things they're doing here in the community. We have a great show for you here in Marty's Corner, the 11th show here in Marty's Corner. We have a gentleman all the way down from Baldwin Park. He's currently a councilman down in Baldwin Park. Dr. Martin Gallegos is here tonight. You ever Martin Gallegos? A very talented lady and a lovely woman is also going to be here. She's a comedian. She's making her Marty's Corner debut here tonight. Can we hear it for Cindy Burns? Cindy Burns here tonight. And continuing with the theme of Madonna, we have a musical group that will be entertaining you here. Two songs tonight. The Love Toyz are here tonight. The Love Toyz are here. Like I said, we'll be back in 3 minutes. Go out and get a sandwich and go to the sandbox and don't go away, guys. Get us out of here. Corner. Hi, I'm your host, Marty Shields.
Leadoff batter for Highlander B hits a ground ball.
Leading my angel would watch over me.
There's no such thing as killer keys.
Oh!
Hi, how you doing? I'm Kevin the Plumber.
Thank you.
gentlemen, alive Friday night here in the City of Industry, Channel 33. Can we hear from Mr. Mike Harrington?
Yay!
Mike Harrington. It's always never a dull moment with Mike around. My co-host for the last year never gets enough airtime because I talk too damn much. Loree, how are you doing this evening?
Great.
Do you have anything you want to say? I mean, this is a chance of a lifetime because I never give you a chance to talk.
Who is that?
This is Loree Sobrito-Jimenez. Loree!
I'm excited because we have a new microphone, or is this something that the boy Toyz brought with them?
No. Well,
can we say that on
the love toys? Love toys.
I mean, the love toys. We're talking
we're
about
live.
Madonna.
We can't edit
I'm
now.
About boy
we
toys.
Can't edit now.
Love toys, boy toys.
Like I said, we have the anniversary show coming up in 1 month from now, actually 5 weeks
That's
from now.
Exciting.
And you're looking forward to it, I know.
I'm excited.
Like I said,
I'm very excited.
You know, if you want more information or ticket information, call me. We have a message on the machine and
on
the
home machine, Marty?
No. It's on a regular one.
Oh,
do you want to move this up a little better? Is that proper?
Okay.
Point it right at her. Boom. So give us a call.
Scary.
Give us a call at 818-369-6339 for more information, and we'll go from there. We'd like to do something we do here every month on Marty's Corner, which is the top nine list. The top nine list on Marty's Corner, which is compiled by our home office in Baldwin Park, California. Baldwin Park?
Yay! Yay!
I'm sorry, Mr. Gallegos, on that one. The top nine list on Marty's Corner, which is always a thrill for us to do, is the top nine categories not chosen on the top nine list this month. The top nine, let's go ahead and go those if we could. Number nine on our list, I'm looking for that. Number nine is top nine corner band fantasies. We don't have it. We don't have it? Do you want me to read that right off the air, or what do you want me to do?
Theater of the mind, Marty. Theater of the mind.
We don't...
They'll have
stall?
To picture it.
Stall.
Okay.
Anybody know any jokes?
Stall.
Oh!
Oh, my gosh.
The magic of TV. The top nine category is top nine reasons... top nine things not chosen for top nine list. I'm sorry. I'm frazzled. Number nine on our list, top nine corner band fantasies.
What?
Top nine corner band fantasies. Two... Three. There!
Oh my God, a number eight popped up too.
That was a sad clap. Number eight on our list, the reasons why Michael Jackson and Lisa Marie Presley shouldn't be married on the top nine. Didn't make it on our top nine list. And the graphics aren't making it on the top nine list. Do you want me to keep going? Oh, we're going to keep going. Heck with it.
Yeah, just keep going.
Number seven on the list, anything to do with Roseanne and Tom Arnold are not going to be
there
on our
we
list.
Go.
Yay!
Oh, there we go.
Roseanne, thank God.
Number six on our list, top nine reasons for the Rams to stay in L.A. The top nine reasons did not make our list. Are any football fans in the audience? Number five on our list, top nine conspiracy theories for the O.J. Simpson case did not make it here on the top nine. Sorry. They're starting to boo me. Number four on the list, top nine reasons baseball players need more money. Did not make it here on our list. Because they're going on strikes. It's a joke.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh. Number three on our list, top nine funniest Marty jokes did not make it here on the top nine. As you can tell.
Bring him next time, Marty.
Starting to sweat. Number two on the list is top nine reasons to see The Lion King again. Top nine reasons to see The Lion King. This top nine is going nowhere. Do you want me to continue with this? And the number one, top nine that did not make it to our top nine list is, I don't know, but please watch the special on the 19th, huh?
Yay!
Oh man, that was bad.
Thank you.
We can only go
you
up from here.
You guys started getting him sweating over here.
I know,
here.
I'm trying to lose it. This time I'd like to bring on someone to Marty's Corner. He's making his first appearance on the corner. He's currently a councilman for the city of Baldwin Park, which you guys didn't clap for, by the way.
And Baldwin Park.
Baldwin
yes.
Park.
Yes. Oh, wow. Baldwin Park.
He's also just been elected as the Democratic nominee to State Assembly. Can you please give a warm welcome to Mr. Dr. Martin Gallegos? Yeah. My goodness. Thank you.
It's nice, comfortable chair.
It is nice, isn't it? Thank you again. Can I call you Doctor or Martin or?
How about Marty? That should be an easy name for you to remember, don't you think?
This is the first Marty we've actually had on the show, besides the first politician. Isn't that nice?
Baldwin Park.
Baldwin Park. Baldwin Park.
Yeah.
I said we're so glad you made it down here this evening, Doctor. And how'd you get into politics? Because you're a doctor, right? And
right.
Where did the politics part come into?
Well, it began, I had a private practice in Baldwin Park for a number of years, and wanted to get involved more in the community, felt I have something to offer. So I ran for city council 4 years ago, and then ran again 2 years afterwards, and I've been on the city council ever since 1990, and just been getting real involved in the community, hoping to make a positive change, and I think we've done that.
I said, I lived in San Gabriel Valley most of my life, and I'm sorry to say that Baldwin Park has a negative look. I mean, there's a lot of gangs over there or violence. And what have you done personally in the city council to try to alleviate some of that problem over there?
Well, Marty, unfortunately, you're right. For many years, Baldwin Park did have that negative reputation. And the city council realized that. And we made it a top priority to change the image of Baldwin Park. And one of the first things we did was we made law enforcement a top priority. Even with the limited funds that city governments have been getting over the last few years, we were still able to boost the police force, make it stronger, put in certain details, special enforcement details that focused in primarily on gang activity or drug activity, prostitution, whatever it was that we needed to address. And by making it a priority, we focused our efforts on that. We were successful in cleaning up the community. In fact, I'm very proud to say that last year, all categories of crime were down in Baldwin Park, which is something that's unprecedented.
You don't hear too much of that going on. I mean, actually, somebody taking the consolidated effort to actually go to the streets and clean it up, and it's working
that's
out
true.
Really well.
It has for Baldwin Park. We're very fortunate.
Another thing that you I know it's in part of your campaign is the schools, the educational system in Baldwin Park, and what are you doing for that, and how are you getting the parents involved in helping out that problem in Baldwin Park?
Well, parental involvement is important in improving the public education system.
Yeah.
We've done all that we can to try to get the community and especially the parents involved in public education in the schools and with their children, because that's what's really important. The children are going to prosper, the children are going to make progress if they know they have the support of the parents, and the parents are there showing that support and demonstrating it to them on a daily basis. So we brought the city and the schools together, working closely to see how we can improve the education delivery process. And we've been very successful, I think, in doing that, in bringing local government, both the school district and the city, out into the people, so we can bring the people closer and get them more involved.
It seems to be working wonders over there. I said,
we're real pleased.
Just the articles I read in the Tribune and stuff are saying that it's actually just going out of the roof right now. Things are really starting to improve on Baldwin Park.
We're very pleased. We feel that it's made a very positive impact on gang activity, on crime, and of course, education, I think, is the key to combating crime. If we have people who are educated, those people who are educated have jobs, then we're going to see a decrease in crime. So it all works together, but I think the main focus comes from
kind of the big cycle,
education.
Isn't it? I mean,
it is.
You hit one, really, and everything works. In Hacienda Heights here, we've had a lot of concerns about the landfill. And I said some of our viewers out there are deeply concerned about the landfill, and I know that's one of your positions that you're trying to hit up. What is your thing on the landfill, and what do you propose to do about that right now?
Well, as I was out during the primary campaign, walking precincts, talking to the people in Hacienda Heights, and I walked a large portion of Hacienda Heights, and without a doubt, the single most important issue on the minds of the residents was the Pointe Hills landfill.
Right.
I've always been on record since I've been in local government as adamantly opposed to the expansion of the landfill that's going to encroach on the natural habitat that we have there, the beautiful wildlife preserves, and of course the canyons. And I've been on public record for that for 4 years. And I think that's what helped gain me support in Hacienda Heights. What I would propose to do is an alternative plan whereby the landfill could expand without encroaching within 75 feet of an elementary school,
right,
or within a few hundred feet of residences. I mean, that's absurd. There is a plan out there now that would allow expansion without encroaching on the wildlife, without getting close to schools, and without getting close to residents. And in the meantime, we can work on developing new technologies that will help us to dispose of our waste without having to bury it in a hole. That's real arcane. I mean, that's an old, antiquated way of dealing with trash.
Sure.
And we need to pursue more contemporary technologies.
Not just you know, see the problem, but actually get something to resolve the problem, as opposed to saying we don't like this, but
right,
you know, have new ideas brought in.
Sure. And that's basically, I think, what has led to my success at the local government level, is the fact that we've been able to bring solutions, not just talked about, not just the rhetoric, but we've actually found solutions and implemented it to solve problems.
You know, politicians are just getting a bad look right now, and you talk about the rhetoric. Where do you think this comes from? Why are politicians so deeply mistrusted these days? I mean, you know, I'm not saying you personally, and
sure,
don't get me wrong, but
thank
I'm saying,
you.
And, you know, not
it
you,
would hurt that,
not
right?
You, Martin, everybody else. what can politicians do to kind of alleviate some of this fear that they can't trust politicians anymore?
Unfortunately, what we're seeing is a lot of the spotlight shed on the few that are unscrupulous, or the few that do engage in unethical activity.
Right.
And that sheds a bad light on all the rest of us who are very credible, have a great deal of integrity, and are really making a personal sacrifice to want to make our communities better. And if I could just send that message to the people, to not be persuaded by, you know, the headlines in the newspaper or the headlines on your local news about corrupt politicians. Yes, sure, we have them. Any profession, any group, I think, has that. But realize that you've got 98% of the group out there who are really dedicated and committed to wanting to make things better, improve the quality of life, and make their area that they represent a better place to live. And it's unfortunate that the mud splatters on all of us, but you know, the good majority of us are really hardworking and devoted people.
Are you looking forward to the election in November?
Oh, absolutely! I can't wait to get the campaign going in full gear. Sure, we're ready to go.
Get all your juices flowing and get out there and start pounding the pavement.
Absolutely, you bet. Looking forward to it.
What kind of doctor are you?
I'm a chiropractor.
Oh, really? I got a crink right here.
Well,
do you?
Okay. Yeah, it's really tight.
You know, and
well, I tell you what.
Set me up.
I'll adjust you, and you let me sit in that chair in Marty's corner. How's that?
I would be glad to do that. That would be no problem.
Actually, that's my true ambition. Is I want to be the host of Marty's Corner one day. So it's a natural.
I always wanted to be a chiropractor. Do you want to say, we need to take off, do you want to say hi to your wife real quick, Rita?
Sure, Rita.
Camera roll.
Hi, oh, there you are, okay. Sorry you couldn't make it, but you know, you're on my mind all the time. Miss you. Wish you could be here.
Thank you. Again, we'd like to thank you so much for coming down, Martin, and being with us tonight. I mean,
hey, Martin, it's my pleasure. I appreciate the invitation.
It was a pleasure for us having you down here. And,
it's a great show. A lot of fun.
We wish you luck in November.
Well, thank you.
And give him heck up in the State Assembly.
You bet.
And can we hear it one more time for Dr. Martin?
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much.
We're going out to commercial. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
It's about 5 minutes to airtime. Has anybody seen Marty? Man, that guy's getting such a big head. Where is he?
I'm here, Mere Mortal. I always wanted to be big in TV. Join me, Marty Shields, on Marty's Corner, Channel 33 Public Access, Friday at 8 o'clock.
Be there!
If you don't, it's all over.
And our next item is Community Access Television, Channel 33. This is local programming not available on any other channel at any price, and we're giving it away free. Just tune in to Channel 33. You're live on Community Access Television. Who's this?
Hi, this is Bobby Puente from Hacienda
Heights. Hi, Bobby. Do you watch Channel 33?
Oh, yes. I watch it all the time. I just love it.
Okay, well, thanks for calling in. Keep on watching Community Access Television, Channel 33. What a great value.
What song was that?
That was
Voodoo
Child by
Andrea. You liar.
Voodoo Child.
No, I don't think it was
Beast
at all.
Beast of Burden.
I Want You to Want Me by Gibson.
Band's right there all the time. Quick as a whip. At this time, I'd like to bring on someone to Marty's Corner, a lovely lady. She'll be making, again, her Marty's Corner debut here tonight. She's come all the way from Orange County. Can you please give a warm welcome to Cindy Burns? Cindy, come on out here.
I am so excited to be here tonight. I am really excited because I got to tell you, I'm a stand-up comic, and when you do stand-up comedy, you never know where they're going to put you, okay? Like last week, I was in Klamath Falls, Oregon. Scariest gig of my life. It was so scary. I performed at this place called Bubba's Comedy Club.
Bubba's.
You know, picture, Bubba weighed about 300 pounds, had that big old beer gut hanging over the belt buckle, you know that thing? And then that butt crack thing pouring out the back there, remember that? Bubba was a woman. Scary, it was just frightening. Okay, I'm having a really bad hair night. I hate my hair. I realize it could be worse. You know, I could look like Richard Simmons. I realize this is an option for me. But it doesn't grow, my hair doesn't grow. 8 years ago, my girlfriend and I decided to grow our hair long, okay? After 8 years, my hair grew like half an inch. Aww. Under my arms, 15, 20 feet. I was whacking it off every day, just hacking it off. On my head, I had a half inch going. Oh, man. Now, my girlfriend, Eileen, her hair grew so long, it went all the way down her back and hung on her butt. I think that's so sexy to feel hair hanging on your butt like that. I mean, I have hair on my butt, too. It's just not growing out of my head. Problem there. I think the person that has the most beautiful hair is that Cindy Crawford. I rented her exercise video. You shut up, okay? Oh, man, that was the most intimidating exercise video, watching Cindy Crawford toss her hair from side to side in a thong leotard. And she, in the front of the video, she goes, anybody can have a hard body. The only thing hard around my house was my husband. Oh, and she's flipping her hair from side to side. It's like, first to the right, then to the left. No, I think it looks much better on the right. No, it looks much better on the left. No, the right, no, the left. I hate that thing. And then she gets so sick of all her hair flying all over the place, she puts it in one of them elastic scrunchies them girls wear. Now she's got this ponytail shooting out the top of her head, and she's flipping and tossing that thing all over. Do you know what my hair looks like in an elastic scrunchie? I'm going to show you guys. Just talk amongst yourselves. You talk amongst yourselves for 1 second.
Just take a moment here. I'm sitting over here
by it. Oh, shit. Oh, man.
There.
Oh.
Do you like the way it just flows out the top, the ponytail?
Yeah.
Get the urge to take me home. Turn me upside down. Maybe scour out a sink. That's about all you can do right here. You guys ever see the Flintstones?
Yeah.
Pebbles at 40. This is it. And she wears that thong leotard, you know what that is, that little string thing,
Yeah.
Oh, I hate those things. You know why? Because I have one of those flat butts, you know, them little pancake kind of butts? You know, it's like a back with a crease down the middle. You put a thong leotard and it slides around on the back of your butt. Just slides around. That thong's just looking for the crease, you know. It's very frustrating. But the first time I put my thong leotard on, I put it on backwards.
Oh,
now
God.
I did like that.
Okay.
I never even made it out to the exercise floor that day. My friends are going, Cindy, hurry up, aerobics is starting. I said, just a minute, I'm coming. I do hate my butt, though. We were at Las Vegas, and those Pepsi girls, you know them, uh-huh, Pepsi girls, were working out at the gym with us, okay? They're working out with us. I'm with my husband. They're wearing sheer-to-the-waist pantyhose with a thong leotard. They have the most incredible butts I've ever seen in my whole life. And the whole time I'm working out, my husband's, like, staring at these girls. I think that is so rude when you're with a girl, yeah, you. And you look, when you're with a girl, they look just us, right? Am I right? I said, honey, is that what you want? Is that what you like? He says, oh, no, baby, I'd much rather have a little white, flat butt like yours. Thank you very much.
I'm glad to see your rear end fits pretty well right
it
there
does.
On the couch.
It just fits fine. There's plenty of padding here, I'm safe.
Okay.
Thank you. With the microphone.
Yeah, now, careful of that microphone. It's very touchy.
I'm very excited, actually. Staring right at my face.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
No, it's all right. I don't know why I'm blushing, Frank. Be quiet. Thank you, Cindy, for coming down. What do you do for a living, Cindy?
I can't stare at anything but that damn microphone.
look into my eyes, Cindy. Look into my eyes.
All right. What do I do for a living?
Yes, Cindy.
Well, I do stand-up comedy.
Uh-huh.
And I do have a day job still.
What do you do? I mean,
I have a health club.
You have a health club?
Yeah,
oh.
I do that.
Where do you get into comedy? Where did that come from?
I think it stemmed from my father. When I was real little, he was always real funny. I mean, there was more emphasis on comedians than homework, you know. If a comedian would come on TV, you know, forget the homework, you know.
So you could turn up the volume and put away the pencils and papers.
Yeah, I think my first memory, I was about 2 years old, and I remember looking across the table, and my dad was sitting at the dinner table, and he had two French fries hanging out of his mouth. And I knew my calling. I knew what it was.
This is Dad, huh?
This is Dad, my role model.
Oh. Jeans.
It's there.
There's
not much in the jeans.
Oh.
In the front, anyway.
Yeah, right.
It's always bad to have two girls with one guy on the set. Just kind of.
Yes, and then this microphone.
I am a third wheel.
Yeah.
I know. Now they have the microphone. They don't need me at all. No. What kind of gigs do you have coming up in Orange County?
Well, I'm going to be going up to Northern California for a week. I'll be on the road. And I'm going to be at Pete's Pizza.
Ooh, Pete's Pizza.
In Laguna Niguel next Friday night. And things come up all the time.
How do you get these gigs? I mean, do you have an agent or something?
Oh, yeah, they're so impressive.
Ooh.
It's really hard work. No, as you can tell, I do act as my own agent.
I could never tell.
I'd have some booking agents out of state that book me out of state. But in Orange County, I just call around myself and get little gigs here and there.
I mean, it's really happening now, isn't it? Comedy for women. I mean, in the years past, it's always been guys, but now it looks
it's
like ladies
been guys.
Are actually.
Ladies are moving in, taking over. It's our turn. Well, we're not taking over, but we're getting our fair share.
I enjoy women to take over every now and then.
Yeah, sure you do.
All right. They're starting. I don't know. You're the comedian. I'll let you stick with the comedy.
Thank you, Mark.
Oh, thank you. I said we need to go out for a commercial break. Do you want to say hi to your husband right there in camera three? Is he right there, that little camera? You want to say hi to him real quick?
Oh, hi, honey.
Does he know where you're at this evening?
Yeah, he knows where I'm at this evening.
That's good to hear. What's your husband's name?
His name is Robert.
Robert. Hello, Robert.
Hi, Robert. I really am here. I really am doing this this evening. I love you very much.
And it's on tape, so actually we're live, so we can actually dub this and he wouldn't know, huh?
It's
I don't want to get Cindy in any more trouble. Again, like I said, we're so glad you came down here today. Can you please give a warm welcome, sorry, give a hand to Cindy Burns. He always welcomed you before. We'd like to bring on a musical group that's been gracious enough to come down and do two songs for us this evening. Let's go ahead and get a shot of this, if we could, on camera with Randy. Why don't you get a shot of this? Apparently, this group has also recently been in this magazine, which is called, of course, Factor X.
My favorite publication.
That's right. I get this religiously at my house. Factor X. And they'll be doing two songs for this evening. Can you please give a warm welcome to the Love Toyz? Take it away, guys. Welcome.
The perfect pair, shadows of places we once knew. When I didn't need you, this much is true. Thank you.
guys, huh? Catherine, why don't everybody introduce themselves first? Why don't you go ahead and give me your name and we'll go down the line here.
I'm James Ray Harper.
I'm Catherine Jensen.
Brian Barnum. Brian over on the other guitar, huh? Outstanding. How'd you guys meet and how'd this get started for you guys?
Well, basically these two knew each other, and James saw me perform at a club, and he came up to me and talked to me afterwards and wanted to know what I was doing. And
that was involved around the music, right?
Yeah, it had nothing to do with any love toys.
No, of course not.
Toys involved.
Of course not, no.
I'm a big boy.
No. Were you a solo act before this?
Yes, for a while I was. And prior to that, I've had other experience. So.
What did you end up meeting Brian, James?
Brian and I met, we were both working at a music store in Covina, Guitar Center, we became good friends. We did a few little projects here and there and worked together, and we're just real good friends. He's a great guy, and just really glad to be working with these guys.
Mutual Admiration Society here. Okay, I would love to. I'll have to grow something. Pigtail! Oh, daisies. I'm going to get a shot of that or not. Oh, it's too late. You have another song you're going to be singing. What, you guys got a gig tonight, don't you?
Yes, we do.
What are you guys playing?
We're playing at Images in Montclair.
Yeah.
That's over off of Mills Road and Holt. It's over by the old Pomona Aztec Mall.
Right.
Right there. It's a new happening rock club.
Yeah.
Come on down.
What time are you guys going on?
We go on at midnight. We've got a late show. But come on out a little earlier, you know, drinks will be served and good time is guaranteed.
That's all we need here.
A good time is guaranteed for all.
You have one more song you've been doing for us tonight, right, James? What song is it?
Hollywood.
Hollywood. Give me one more time for the Love Toys. Ladies and gentlemen, the Love Toys.
Jenny took a ride on a Greyhound bus, headed out west, and she doesn't want to come out from Hollywood. No homecoming queen, but she could sing and dance. All she wants is to have a chance.
Hollywood, all the dreams you
headed up, hustling on the streets at night. Got hooked and cracked, she's always high as a kite. In Hollywood, her daddy came looking for his little girl. He found her washed up on the Santa Monica shore. Damn Hollywood. All the dreams and millions wrapped up just in me. Tell me what's a poor country girl supposed to do?
You think you might have talent on you, may feel so proud.
Here, ladies and gentlemen, the last few minutes before we get out of here and I'll go home. I said, Mike Harrington, besides being the person who pumps up the crowd and stuff, is also a producer here at Channel 33. Let me go over real quick with Mike. Why don't you go and follow me over, Norma, I guess. And Mike, what do you got going as far as things coming up on your show and what's going on?
I'm working on a couple more shows, okay. And I'm hoping, I'm crossing my fingers, a lady named Jennifer Patan, she's Michael Jackson's lead guitarist. She toured with him on his last two world tours. She has a solo project. She's playing at the Rude Dog in Covina next Saturday. And I've given them a tape of my work. And hopefully the managers will locate me for me to come down and video for the show and put it on this channel.
So I'm really excited.
That was the quickest 2 minutes I've ever heard in my life. Again, I said, Mike, thank you so much. Mike Harrington, ladies and gentlemen.
You never ask the band if we have anything planned.
You guys have anything planned, Frank?
No.
Okay.
Oh, you never ask.
At this time, we'd like to go ahead and do the calendar of events that we always do at Marty's Corner, and that lets you know what's going on in the community this weekend and the weeks to come. Let me go ahead. The first one is called the Roaring Twenties Roar Again for Free. Down at the Homestead Museum in Hacienda Heights, it will be Ian Whitcomb and his dance band.
Oh, he's really good.
That's right. And they'll present a concert from the past at 6:30 p.m. July 21st at the Homestead Museum, 15451 East Don Julian Road, City of Industry. The free concert will feature popular songs from the Roaring Twenties,
along with the novelty tunes and also vintage jazz.
You're doing also a Herbert Hoover fashion show.
Kind of like that, kind of a theme. For information, call 818-968-8492. Loree, take it away.
Of course, I never pick things that are in the community. I pick things where you have to drive and you have to spend a lot of money. So, like a typical woman, right? Spend a lot of money. And you
I'm
have to drive, and then
it
you
is.
Get mad at your husband because you're lost, and then directions get messed up, and he won't stop at the gas station and ask directions.
And women
anyway.
Can't get to the point. Keep going around. You know, go ahead, Loree. Take
Getting to the point, I highly recommend, who hasn't been to see the Genghis Khan exhibit at the L.A. County Museum of Natural History, is that what it's called?
I haven't seen it.
It's incredible. It's only there through August 14th. Call for information, 213-744-3506. I recommend it. It's incredible.
Incredible. Is the word.
You've got to go see it.
Why is it incredible?
It just is.
It takes you back.
History.
Before we go out, we also found recently that we're not only being shown in Hacienda in La Puente and also West Covina, but also recently, we've been picked up in the city of Walnut. Come here for Walnut! Yay! Marty's Corner is now in Walnut.
And I hear they're nuts about us over there.
They're absolutely nuts about us. Before we go out, again, we'd like to tell you and implore you, please, to come down on August 19th, the VFW Hall, the City of Industry. It's on Gale and Ward Avenues. Post 1944. That'll be our one-year anniversary. It's also a fundraiser for the POW, MIAs, and also the Buddy Poppies Foundations. $5 donation gets you in to see the show for 2 hours from 8 to 10. And then from 10 to 12, we're going to celebrate the show, and we'll have dancing and eating and drinking and all kinds of
things. And guests that were on the show before.
And we're going to have like 6 comedians and a bunch of bands and dancers and more fun that you can...
We'll be there too, Marty.
A good time.
More fun than
we'll
you thank you, Jimmy. More fun with than
Crazy
a,
Mike will
a puppy
be there.
With two Peters.
There's that microphone again.
Thank you, Jim. I know. Get this. But like I said, we like to thank everyone in the last year for coming to Marty's Corner and supporting us and what we're doing here in the community. Again, you can see us on August 19th. Give us a call if you have any questions about the show. 818-369-6339. You want to say goodbye, Loree?
Goodbye, Loree.
Take it away, guys. God bless. Take care. Bye-bye.